What's up, it's your boy Quinn.
And I'm your boy Delta Young, and you're watching The Rising 10, your source for local entertainment. And welcome back to The Rising 10, your source for local entertainment. You know we got the best show in store for y'all today. Because we got my boy, Cam Horton, of the Jacksonville Golden Eagles, coming in here, showing us how he do on the court. But first, you know, we all got our own grills. And you know, the first thing you need to tell them to do is to take your hand. And that's exactly what Young Hustle did in his video. Go ahead and show him.
It's official.
Bye.
I said I want you to be my lady. Stick together forever, just take my hand, girl. I want you to be my lady, and I can be your man. We can stick together forever, just take my hand, girl.
I wanna be your lady, and I want you to be my man. I'm down to ride forever, however, just take my hand, boy. I wanna be your lady, and I want you to be my man. I'm down to ride forever, however, just take my hand, boy.
Too young for marriage, our love is so far from average. Loyalty has been established, a bond that you can't imagine. Anything she wants, she have it. I treat my queen so lavish, diamonds in latest fashion. Her happy, my only passion. All smiles, I keep her laughing. She mind, no questions asking. Our romance is fantastic, stress free, nothing dramatic. For affection, I'm an addict. No assassin, I attack it. I enter in her dragon, I'm fire, no one can match it.
I want you to be my lady, and I can be your man. We can stick together forever, just take my hand, girl. I want you to be my lady, and I can be your man. We can stick together forever, just take my hand, girl.
I wanna be your lady, and I want you to be my man. I'm down to ride forever, however, just take my hand, boy. I wanna be your lady, and I want you to be my man. I'm down to ride forever, however, just take my hand, boy.
Now this week has been a great week in music because you got my boy August L. Cena dropping his album Testimony.
Right, and you got Future coming out with a new album, Honest.
And then you got my girl Iggy Azalea dropping a new classic.
Yeah.
And we gonna give you our honest reviews of these albums, rating them 1 out of 10. Mm-hmm. First starting with August L. Cena, Testimony. Now what was you thinking when you heard that album?
It really brought out the realness in his music and it showed who he is as a person. He really put that in his music and I thought that was really dope, man.
See, where I like it, you know, when you listen to his album, you're not going to hear any generic C in it. And what I mean by that is you're not going to hear like the same rehashed song, the same baby, I just want to love you, all that stuff back and back to back.
Right.
You're going to hear some original ideas put into music, which is it's not really presented by new artists at all, you know, especially when they dropping their first project.
Right.
And so for him to do that, that's really, really, really dope. I'ma give it a Delta Young rating of 9 out of 10. Cause you know, it's a little more he could've added, but it was near perfect.
Exactly, exactly. I give it the same, 9 out of 10. I give it the same.
All right, moving on to my boy Future with his album, Honest.
Yeah. Okay. Now, I gotta say, I'll give him the respect as in the production of the music. I feel like it's at a little bit more of a higher level. You hear when the album first comes in, it sounds a little bit different. It's the intro isn't just straight hardcore like come at you. It has a little bit of twang to it, and I think that's good. But as soon as he comes in, you hear that same future flow.
See, for me, when I was listening to the album, it was just disappointing because you know, looking at it from a customer standpoint or a fan standpoint, why would I pay for music I already have?
Right.
And, you know, if you release it on a mixtape, don't put it on your album. An album and a mixtape are two different things, and people don't want to go and buy something they already have for free. You know, I feel like Honest is probably going to be the most pirated album of 2014. Why?
Honest.
Because, you know, Future is really, really big in urban areas and stuff like that. And so, you know, they have no reason to buy that because it's, you know, they already had it. So they might go and download it illegally to get those few songs that, you know, they can't get. But pretty much that, you know, it's not worth the buy.
Exactly. I bet you $20 right now if you go on YouTube, you will have the full album on that. And that's sad to say, but
yeah,
that's probably going to be the outcome.
I give it a 1 out of 10, you know?
I'll give him about a 4 or 5.
4 out of 5. All right, moving on to my girl, Iggy Azalea with the new classic. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and tell y'all straight out the back, if y'all wanna support female hip hop, she is one to support. Like, she is not just a one-hit wonder, and she's showing you this on her album. Go cop that one pronto. Starting off with the first song all the way to the end. You know, if you're not a fan of the poppy type rap, don't listen to the later half of the album. But the beginning is really, 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 really core hip-hop, and she's really, really showing that she is a competitor in the rap industry. She is someone to look out for. What you think?
Like, I mean, I felt like that album make you really want to see what she has coming up next, mm-hmm. you know? Because not a lot of people really know of Iggy Azalea. I mean, she's a big mainstream artist, but I think this album is really gonna bring
her. Because you know, her popularity is really overseas in like the UK.
Right.
And I feel like this album and her singles are really, really, really gonna bring it to the USA, and she's gonna have a big popping USA fan base. You know, even with Fancy, she dropped Fancy and it had like the Clueless movie thing. So all the girls is already going to it already because they're like, oh, that's my movie.
Yeah.
Clueless? I love that. And so, you know, Iggy Azalea, that's the album you need to be copying. I give that, since it's her first album, and she really, you can really tell she put her all into it to not be generic, to not copy anybody, to stay in her own lane. You know, it's really, really entertaining album.
Right, it is.
It's really, you don't get bored with it. And so, you know, and that's a thing, it's like a movie. You have to be able to keep my attention. And I'm gonna give it a DLTM rating of a 10 out of 10.
10 out of 10? I give it about, my opinion, I give it like an 8. I'll give it an 8.
And that's our reviews. But coming up next, guess who we got, bruh? We got Cam Horton of the Jacksonville Eagles coming on the set. You don't want to miss it. Stay with us after this break.
Trophies, ain't no envelopes to open. I just do it cause I'm supposed.
What's up, we're back with your boy Cam Horton. How you been? What you been up to?
And I've been good, staying healthy, still playing, you know, trying to get up out of here.
Alright. Man, last time I saw you on the court was when you were playing Alexandria. That's my home team, man. And even though we all rivals and everything, I gotta say I really respect you, man. How do you feel about that whole rivalry and everything? How does that speak to you?
And it's real intense, you know, when you play Alexandria, the night before you up all night thinking about how you gonna do this, how you gonna do that. And when the game time come, you gonna hear fans and coaches, it's gonna be there. It's a good atmosphere.
So, you know, this season was a great season for you, you know, and it's still fresh in your mind because this ended not too long ago. So, you know, what's your best game so far? What do you think's your best game?
I had to say sacks, you know, because I picked it up. First half, I shot, played around a little too much, and then second half, I picked it up, and it felt like I was throwing a rock into a creek or something. So I had the hot hand. Coach told me to shoot. That's what I did.
Great.
So what really influenced you to play basketball, man?
And all my friends are telling me, like, you need to come play par. Because I played football with them, you know. And after football, I just sat at home and played video games. Yeah. So once they told me, you know, come play par, I was like, man, I don't know. And about round 10, that's when I first started playing and been going on since then.
Now, speaking of 10,
you were in 10th grade this past year, and you had to have been like the youngest person on the team. So how was that? You being a point guard, you had to have in some way kind of led the team. How was that?
It started off rough first, you know. Seniors and juniors, they don't like listening to a 10th grader. Right. So I had to basically speak up, you know, ask God to help me, mm-hmm. what I'm gonna do to get these boys to listen to me, and he gave it to me, and the boys, they listened to me later on, you know. Start off.
Bet. Now, I know you're a good basketball player and all that, but, you know, it's always that tough person, you feel me? Who was the hardest person for you to guard?
Yeah, you know, I gotta say Chris English, you know. He a big physical guard, you know. He's not only just a point guard, mm-hmm. he can put you in a small forward mentality. Like he'll put you in the post and then bring you right back out with that speed. So
yeah,
that's why I say he's one of the most.
Yeah, see, Chris English on the show not too long ago, so, you know, we know about a little bit about Chris English over here, so we know he a beast,
you know. I respect him. I got in the gym with him this summer a little bit, not often, but we got in there, and he's real.
Now, do you think, you feel me, don't feel free to brag, you feel me, but do you think you're the best player in the camp?
Well, you know, since Chris gone, I'm gonna have to say, yeah, you know, I got, you know, other players besides, you know, like DJ Heath, Deontay Woods, you mm-hmm. know, Quinn Williams from Sacks. I got them, but
you're the best player.
I honestly think I am, because I got, you know, them boys got some, you know, they got stuff that I can't do that they can do, mm-hmm. but I think I'm like, I got the whole package.
Yeah.
You got, you know, 2 more years ahead of you, so you got a lot more room for, you know, to better yourself, you know?
Yeah, yeah. So what's your goals for next season?
To be honest, I want to go farther in the county tournament than we did this year. You mm-hmm. know, we lost second round. I want to at least get there to the championship game. And then area tournament, I want to win that and get to JSU from JSU Birmingham, and hopefully we'll get that ring.
Yeah. Well, hopefully you can make this ring last a long time, you feel me? Don't change the TVs just yet, because we're coming up on our first music video. Well, no, it's not the first, it's the second music video. And this is Pretty Boy with R9.
To come over.
Phone goes off.
It's you again. Wanted me to come over so I can break your back in.
Girl, give me 30 minutes. I'ma get in. I'm on that thing. I ain't trying to win.
No.
Yeah, I'ma beat it down. But just to watch you finish.
What?
Yeah, I love the look upon your face when I get you off. Baby, I stay rock hard while he keeps going so.
Damn.
You said all y'all ever do is argue and fight. So when I hop off in them sheets, it's always feeling right. After seeing what it do, little mama, I had to get you. Cause you a beautiful masterpiece, and I wanna paint the picture. Yeah, I always try to knock it out, no baseball bat. And after I leave, you're telling your friends that.
Now I'm back kicking it with Cam Hornstead. He gonna be with us for the rest of the episode. Now, I know you heard about this little situation that's going on, you know, with the Clippers owner. He made some racist remarks. Now, how you feeling about that?
You know, that racial stuff, you know what I'm saying, we supposed to put that behind us. And, you know, for him, you know, to pay African Americans, you know, and then he go back and tell his girlfriend and stuff like that, it ain't right. You know, he was mad at her because she made a picture on Instagram with Magic Johnson. He said, don't publicize black people on Instagram or don't bring them to my games. So, you know, I was like, dang, you got black players on your team, you feel me? So why would you do that? You know, that'll make me not want to play for him, you know?
Yeah, see, exactly. That's when I first read the story. I was like, automatically, if I'm a basketball player for him, it's over with. I'm done.
So, right,
it's gonna be a because it's an automatic problem. It's an automatic problem because I'm black, and at the end of the day, you paying me to be on your team, and that's a sly remark saying I really don't like y'all, but y'all. What's the nice way to say it? Y'all in words can play basketball, but y'all ain't good enough.
Exactly,
and that ain't right.
Exactly, that's not right at all.
My last game for him would have been my last.
Yeah. So what the player saying? Y'all know what the player saying? Anything came out about what the player saying at all?
You know, I heard Kobe Bryant say I couldn't play for him. LeBron said, you know, I feel sorry for Chris Paul being under that type of situation. Mm-hmm. And I heard about stuff like that. But
what the team? Ain't nothing came up with the team themselves.
Nah, but I probably know Chris Paul. He got some. He'll have something to say later on. He will.
Whew, that's a good game right there. That's a very, very tough one, man. I'm pretty sure that everybody in the studio, that's an automatic no-go.
Nope.
So you can't too much brag about anything like that, you feel me? Because, you know, not with that type of owner being a part of your team.
Exactly.
But you know, when you James Boss, you can brag about anything,
exactly.
Bro. Anything. Because he got bragging rights automatically, bro. And that's our next video, bragging rights.
When your miss ain't drop, it's coming real soon. It's game four and I'm up, go ahead and bring the broom. I want Gucci this, and Louis that. Everything designer, yeah, you know I miss the match. Trilogy fiend, and they on my jeans. And yeah, they all white, you know I had to keep them clean. And he don't wanna talk swag. I swear to God, I ain't trying to brag.
Now we still got Cam with us, but we're gonna play a little game called Who Is It? Now Cam is facing this way, so he don't know who's on the screen, and we're gonna try to get him some characteristics of whoever's on the screen, you know, so and see if he can figure it out. Starting off, okay. let's go with the best driver's guy.
This dude got so much money, it don't make no sense, man.
He make you feel some type of way anytime.
His homie's been hustling since, you know, you feel me?
He can't judge you. He gonna get that stuff off you.
Rich homie coin.
Rich homie coin, yeah.
Word.
I love this. If I don't make it home tonight, him and Rich homie got a problem. He had a problem with Trey Songz.
On 106.
He had an incident on
106.
You know what? We just talked about him on the show.
We
did?
Testimony. He got all the tattoos. All the females want him.
Jesus?
He had an album. Not an album, but a song with Jeezy.
Yeah. Come on, man. You got to know
it. You got this one. You got it.
I don't know.
Oh, my God.
All right.
That was all I've ever seen of, bro.
Yeah.
Dang. All right. She pregnant.
She got her boyfriend.
Her boyfriend Future.
Oh, she here?
Right. Yeah, she pregnant, really narrowed it down.
Okay. Oh, she used to be a female rapper.
Yup. Until Nicki Minaj came along and they had their little beef.
Look him.
Anybody else? Okay. She reckless.
She loves sticking her tongue out.
Man, they got her thinking that she invented twerking.
Word. No.
It ain't Nicki.
No.
Come on,
Beyonce?
Now. No.
She had to cut her hair off.
She cut her hair off.
She used
to be on Disney Channel. Yeah, there you go.
Very good.
She invented twerking.
All right. And now we're going to get into our next music video. Nicki Minaj, Tiger, Lil Wayne, See Now.
Can you see now? Are you seeing now? Can you see 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 now? When you see a nigga, maybe I can see now.
Sky roller check, helicopter pad, dropping off a body bag. Money talk, guess I got the gift for gab. Don't interject, don't intercept. You ain't on a jet, you ain't need it with this kind of money. Yeah, I gotta order more, I ain't set the time once. And I know they say they shine, I ain't seen them shine once. All these rappers is my sons and I'm always 9 months. Man, if this was baseball, I ain't let them slide once. Do you see now? You playing D now? Oh, you wanna beat me? Why? Oh, you the number one draft in the league now? Ride down your block doors, 12 o'clock, Lambo to drop bikes, and they ain't stopping for a car. Got this tighter than a bear hug. When them just rap, you give me the earplug.
Can you see now? Are you seeing now? Can you see now? Are you seeing now? Can you see now? Can you see now? Can you see now? When you see anyone, they get to see now. Ride with the heat, trunk full of beat bomb like the Middle East. I got killers in the street. Ride with the heat, trunk full of beat bomb like the Middle East. I got killers in the street. Ride with the heat, trunk full of beat bomb like the Middle East. I got killers in the street. Ride with the heat, trunk full of beat bomb like the Middle East. I got killers in the street.
Just got a problem, see about it. Not again, I'll beat the body. I'm just making all these deposits. Neighborhood nice and quiet. Thought I saw Mr. Rodney, nigga. I can sell salt and equalizer. Wait, I said I can sell salt and equalizer. Boy, I got every award for the Heisman door.
Now, welcome back. Now, if you're trying to get a music video on the countdown, you know what to do. Email us at therisingtntv@gmail.com or visit our website at tv24.tv/therising10. Easy as pie. Now, I want to start off again a shout out to McCare Media for hooking me up with this fresh shirt to match with my fresh epic hat. You feel me? If you're looking for a nice shirt to wear, this is the shirt to get. If you need to go to the studio, best studio around, you need to go to them.
I want to appreciate you for coming out, man. Nice of you to come on, man. I really respect what you're doing. Anybody want to shout out?
Man, shout out to D, KJB, you feel me? Terry Thomas, Jacksonville, my mom, God, y'all too, you feel me? Everybody.
All right, and we're going to bring it to our last music video of the night. Our ladies finna go crazy because it's August and Cena with Make It Home.
Corners trying to shake a couple cats.
I broke a couple.